How did you do that?
Whoa!
Holy
cow!
Oh boy!
All you have to do is ask.
Hey guys, how y'all doing out there? It's time for another tutorial from Pinnacle Studio Pro. Another basic tutorial request? Yes, I have been getting so many requests on how to adjust the volume in Pinnacle Studio 17 Ultimate. So I'm bringing you two quick and easy ways to edit the volume in the timeline. Let's get into it. First and foremost, you need to have either an audio track or clip down in the timeline track, or you need to have a video clip that has audio, and you can tell that the video clip has audio by the waveform that you see here at the bottom of the video clip. Now, the first thing I'm going to show you is the audio mixer. First thing you want to do is you want to enable the track that has the video clip on it. Keep in mind, all of the video clips on this timeline track will be adjusted by the volume if you use the audio mixer. So make sure if you only want to adjust the clip on for one of your video clips, then you want to make sure that's the only one on the track and don't put anything else on the track after it if you use this method. So you want to activate the track by left clicking on it, and once you do, it'll turn light gray. Then you go here to the audio mixer. You click on this and it's going to open up all of your settings. First, you got your metering to tell how high your volume is. If you go into the orange or the red, then you're going too high. Your volume is way too high. All right. Now, the next thing you got is your master volume. You can just place your cursor over this, hold down the left mouse and drag it to the left or to the right to adjust the volume. Or you can click in this little box with the number, and then you can change the number. Next, you got your adjust the volume of your current position on the clip. This only works if you have like keyframes enabled, and I'll talk about enabling keyframes. Right now, if I move it, it's gonna move the whole green line up and down, which is changing my whole volume. It's not really changing it just at that spot. All right, you gotta have keyframes enabled for that to work. Then you have your surround sound or your stereo panning. So if I click on this, I'm given some options here. Let me go ahead and remove these keyframes. All right, so you got a few presets. First, you got center channel off. What that means is all of the speakers will be on except for the center speaker. You see the center speaker is grayed out. Then you got 5.1. 5.1, now the center speaker is on as well, and so are all the other speakers. And then you have dialogue mode, and when you turn that on, only the center speaker and the speakers behind the viewer will be on. Now, those are the presets, but you have control over how it works. You can drag the little grab point here to the left, and then only the two left speakers will be on, or to the right, and only the right speakers. Or you can drag this grab point down, and only the rear speakers will be on, or the top, depending on what you're doing here. And then you can grab the center, and then you can have everything with the same exact volume, and the people in the center will be getting the lusciousness of beautiful volume. And then you also have the ability to keyframe this out and add keyframes at certain points when you're making adjustments to the volume. Let's say you want for one scene it to be just this speaker on, and you can drag the little blue dot down here. If you just want this speaker on, you can do the same. If you just want, you know, so it's all over the place. It's a good little thing here. So I'm gonna go center channel off, and I'm gonna remove all the keyframes I made, and we're good to go. So that's your first option, just adjusting the whole video clips or video clip on a track with the master volume and the audio mixer. Second option, over here to the right on the toolbar, right underneath the preview window, you have a little squiggly line, looks like a S or whatever. This is called the volume keyframing button. When you click on and activate it, it turns orange. And now I could add keyframes and adjust my volume by clicking on the green volume bar in the waveform. Beautiful. So click on it and you add a keyframe. Once you do, you can, once you have more than one keyframe, you can start changing the volume, because you can't just change it with one. I mean, if I changed it now, it'll just change the volume of everything. It'll just drag it up or down. But if I add another keyframe here, let's say, and I pull it straight down, then I will cause a fade. Everything after this will be down at the bottom. And if I create another keyframe here, and then another keyframe after it, I can drag it back up, and now I have a position where it fades down to the bottom and fades back up. If I want to change my fade, I could just move these bars up a little bit and add more volume to it. And if I had, let's say I had a part of the scene where there was some mistake that I made, but I still want to have the screen up, this wouldn't really be something that you do a lot, but I could add a keyframe here, here, and drag this one all the way down, and then drag it right under it, and it'll lock into place magnetically. And this means that my volume will stop at this point. If I make another keyframe here and then another keyframe after that, I can drag this last one up and above the other one. And now this part will just be completely muted. So let's see how it sounds.
Have to do is ask.
Hey guys, how y'all doing out there? It's time for another tutorial from Pinnacle Studio Pro. Some of you out there might feel that this is a basic tutorial, but I have been getting crazy requests to do a tutorial on cropping videos and photos. So you know I had to bring it to my Pinnacle peeps. Let's get into it. And then I also got a clip in the timeline of Easy Peasy Lemon Squeezy. There you go. Two ways to adjust the volume in Pinnacle Studio 17 Ultimate. Hey peeps, you know what to do for me. Hazme un favor, por favor. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction. Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Comments. I love your comments, all right? Good, bad, and different, I don't care. I love them, all right? If you need help, I'll get back to you. If I can't help you, I'll point you in the right direction to get you the help you deserve. And last, but definitely not least, don't you ever forget to subscribe, baby. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon. We'll be right back.